Welcome to Chris Budget Gear Reviews. Today we're going to be taking a look at the Amerglo XL Height Fits All Glock Models GL611s. Once again, the Amerglo Model Golf Lima 611. Now I actually have these sights on my Gen 5 Glock 17. And they are some good, decent sights. I like them. They do hit low point of impact, but not by a lot. Now, the Palmer St. Army Dagger do come with suppressor height of sights, but these have to be the XXL height of sights. Now, to kind of give you a visual representation, you can visually see that the sights that come on the Palmetto St. Army Dagger are slightly taller than the ones on the Amerglos. You can even see it in the front sight post too. Now what I'll do is, once we go ahead and get into the installation process, because that's what this video is about, we're going to be putting these sights on the Palmetto St. Army Dagger, and we're going to use this right here, the VISM Universal Pistol Rear Sight Adjustment Tool. It worked for my Glocks. It should work for the Palmetto St. Army Dagger. Once we get to that point where we got both sights from off of each gun, we may go ahead and break out the caliber and actually measure it so we can get an actual solid determination that the sights that are on the Palmetto St. Army Dagger are taller than the Amerglo sights. So we may break out the caliber, we may measure everything. But with that being said, let me go ahead and set this up because we are about to get straight into the installation. Okay, so we got it set up. Now what we're not going to do is we're not going to go through the entire process of me removing the sights and everything like that. The main thing that you as a viewer want to see is, can your $50, $60 Amazon bought sight pusher work with the Amerglo sights when you're installing them on your PSA dagger? That's the most important thing you want to see. I will show you a small portion once I get like halfway through or something like that, but I'm not going to sit here and make you watch me as I'm turning it and everything like that. So let's go ahead. Let me go ahead and start working on it a little bit. We'll come back when we get halfway and I'll let you know how everything's working out. All right. We are at the halfway mark and it works. Pushing it right on out. As you can see, we're at the halfway mark and it's starting to loosen up now. I will say this right here, your biceps, your forearms, and a little bit of your shoulder muscles, you're going to get a nice little workout, for sure, without doubt, but yes, it works. Also, I see why VISM have these little screw holes right here, so you can actually bolt it down to like the bench or the table or something like that. But yeah, it works though. We're pushing it, we got it halfway out, it's a lot more easier to push now. As you can see, I don't have to struggle as much. And you can see it's pushing right on out. And basically, it's out. We could just tap that the rest of the way out. But, yep, it works. Let's go ahead, push them up. Well, matter of fact, let's go ahead and measure them right quick. Let me measure the rear sight right quick. Let me set that up. And there go both rear sights. We got the Palmetto St. Army Dagger sights that was on there on the left. And we got the Amerglos on the right. And you can visually see that it's a difference. But what we go ahead and do is, let me get this caliber. Where is it at? Right here. And I measure it off camera. Let's see. So measuring it like that right there, you got 0.42. Measuring the Amerglo the same exact way, you got 0.39 and we need a new battery. But you got 0.39, so there is a clear difference in the height of the rear sight. And we could just assume if it's a difference in the height of the rear sight, it's definitely going to be a difference in the height of the front sight. So I just wanted to kind of see that for myself. So yes, there is a difference, 0.3 of an inch difference. So that's very significant. Matter of fact, let me measure one more thing too. This might be even more significant right here. Let's do that inside channel right there. That inside channel right on that part right there. 0.31. Measuring the same inside sight channel, 0.27. So yeah, it's a big difference. Yep. Let's go ahead and push these Ameriglobes on. Alright, let's come on back with an update. We're starting to push it in now. Probably won't be able to do this too good but around the camera, but it's pushing it. It's getting it in there. Like I said, your forearms, your biceps, and your shoulder muscle are going to get a nice, good workout, too. If you go to the gym, you might want to do this on a day when you ain't got to go to the gym. But, yeah. It's getting on there, though. Once we get it on there, I'll come back and show you. All right. Mission accomplished. So the main thing you wanted to see in this video, will the sight pusher you have work for the Palmer to say Army Dagger? The answer is yes. Because we just installed the rear sight of the Ameriglobe on the Palmer to say Army Dagger. Now I do need to kind of make fine-tune adjustments. I actually like for my rear sight to be sitting a little bit over to the right to compensate for that low left that us right-hand shooters have. I kind of got it set up on my Genside Glock 17. You can kind of see where it's offset a little bit to the right. Just a little bit. I actually know the exact measurements. But yeah, it will work. That's the main thing that you wanted to see. Y'all be blessed. Be safe and I'm out. And when you get ready to do this, make sure you got you a good cup of coffee. Because it's a workout on your shoulders and your biceps. I'm out.